Hi, I'm Jasmine Greenaway, and I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. In software development, it's important to consider and be prepared for when things go wrong. We can do this in our code. So let's explore how to handle errors in JavaScript. Exceptions are interruptions in the intended execution of code. And this is typically caused by errors. And errors are when things go wrong in our code. For example, if you write incorrect syntax in JavaScript, sometimes your code won't execute at all. You can think of errors as what went wrong in your code, and exceptions as where and when it went wrong. When something goes wrong in your code, you'd like to know why. So when an exception is thrown, it carries a message telling you what went wrong in your code. Exceptions can be thrown by JavaScript or manually by the developer. This example shows two exceptions being thrown manually. When you throw an exception, you can send some additional information along with it. This can be anything from a primitive data type all the way to a complex object. It's really up to you. This exception is throwing a string and a Boolean. Uncaught exceptions can be critical, dangerous, or confusing interruptions. So it's important that we tell our code what to do next when these situations arise. And we do this with try, catch, and finally. Try monitors the lines of code that might potentially throw an exception, while catch will handle what happens when an exception is thrown. And finally, we'll optionally control the flow of code even when an exception is not thrown. In this example, we're using only try and catch. In this first example, imagine we have some critical code in a function called critical code. This is code that could potentially throw an exception. If that happens, we'll catch the exception in the catch block. First, it'll log an error to the console, then it'll call a function to log the specific exception that happened so that we can look at it later. In this example, we're throwing the exception ourselves. So when it gets caught in the catch block, it'll print to the console and it'll log the error for us to read later. In this try, catch, and finally example, the code that's in the finally block will run every time, whether or not an exception is thrown.